Hey, this is Nightflame, and today I will be reviewing Batgirl number 29. So in this issue, it opens up with, the continuation where Strix and Batgirl were held up by the police, also with Silver and her beautiful henchmen. Yeah, and they get held up, and Silver escapes in this weird manner. He cuts his neck, and he, like, flips backwards in top of his car. The police are, like, fascinated, because they probably would have thought that he killed himself, but he didn't. And then Silver's car starts opening fire all over the policeman. He has like this little, it shoots a lot of bullets. I don't know what it's called. I know the name, but I forgot it. So they start shooting the police's car, and Strix and Batgirl escape, because that's their time to escape, you know, or else the police are gonna know that's the commissioner's daughter. They escape, and then they have this really cool moment when they find the location where Silver's secret hideout is, and you know how Strix doesn't talk? She's like, if girl is hurt, I kill. Do not try to stop. Because, you know, she doesn't talk. The little girl doesn't talk either. So she has this connection to her. And we also see that Batgirl's like, oh no, I'm not going to take you. If you kill, I'm not going to take you. And then she puts a note that says promise, but the end half of the note, it's like bended, so you can't see what it is. And then we later see that it says promise to kill. We didn't see that. Batgirl didn't see that because she only saw the promise part. But it says promise to kill, which I thought that was, I think Silver's gonna die. Silver gets healed. His neck gets, like, wrapped up in, to heal because he cut himself, which was weird. And we find a little bit of a character flashback on why Silver does this. He apparently thinks that the Bat people killed his mother, and he couldn't even do anything because she was cold. There was no trail of blood. He thinks that this little girl is the Bat's leader. He thinks that she's a vampire queen, and he talks to her. He's like, "Oh yeah, you little demon." And we think that she's not the vampire queen because, you know, she's just a little girl. So Strix and Batgirl get into his house. They find out that she actually is a vampire, which was really weird, actually. The little girl is a vampire. She bites Silver in the neck. And then a vampire comes and says, his name is Vampire. He takes her because she apparently supposed to be dead. That's just a shell of her body. I didn't get that part. And that's the end of the issue. Batgirl's like, oh yeah, how do I convince myself that this actually happened? You know, it's all weird. So what's the point of this? That's what I think. We introduced Silver, which I thought was going to be a pretty interesting character. But no, he kind of is like a joke. He doesn't do anything. He's really skilled. But at the end, he's not a criminal anymore because his objective is done. So I give Batgirl issue 29 7. The storyline's like, oh yeah, I shouldn't have been there. I know that Batgirl has like been out of the, on. I mean, it used to be on a roll with a wanted storyline, but since tie-in after tie-in, kind of like get off track, and this story arc was a story arc that kind of like wasn't needed to progress anything. And yeah, I just think it's a 7 out of 10. Batgirl is a really good book, but this storyline wasn't the best she had, or it wasn't the worst either, but it was just really weird. So thanks for watching, subscribe and like this video.